In 1967, a winning precedent was set at Reagan High School. A tradition was established on a kickoff return and a goal line stand.
It'll be fielded on the 3-yard line by Johnny Kleinert, out to the 10, the 20, 25, 30, look out, 40, breaks loose, and Kleinert is at the 50-yard line. He's going all the way, nobody to stop him, and on the opening kickoff, Kleinert goes all the way, and it's a Raiders 6-0! This is the big play of the ball game, fourth and goal from the one.
The men who set the tone for the Reagan Raider football empire were men of conviction, toughness, and inspiration. The Reagan Raiders were back-to-back national champions in 1967 and 68. In 1969, they failed to make the playoffs, leaving the 1970 bunch hungry to reclaim the state title. On a cold day in December in San Angelo, Texas, they etched their own legacy in Texas high school football history.
They're kind of a tough bunch of individuals. They then fight you over a dime, and they work hard at anything that they've gotten, and they're real close.
Driving the middle is Mitchell. He's close. He's in. Touchdown.
And now throwing to Doug Mitchell. The score is for the Austin Reagan Raiders.
Quarter knows what it has to do. They line up in the wishbone tee this time, and the fake to the first man, a quick pitch, intercepted, stolen away by Scotty Ceder, and he goes all the way for the touchdown. Quarterback Larry Miller was trying to pitch that ball out to Dan Justice. I believe they had two men out, or Ben Montgomery, rather, trying to pitch it out to either Dan Justice or Jamie Berryhill. He had them both out there, but Scotty Ceder, the strong side safety, had pulled up tight, and he stole it and went all the way into the end zone, about 30 yards for the score. And now Billy Schott for the extra point. Snap, set, kicked up, and it is good once again. And that only took about 8 seconds, 5 minutes and 3 seconds remaining to play in this opening quarter. We'll be right back.
boys of fall in Northeast Austin truly were the kings of the gridiron, not only in Texas, but in the entire nation as well.
And you got a song. The boys of fall.